गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द टॉपिक ट्रांसपोजेबल एलिमेंट. इन अवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक वी हैव डिस्कवर दैट देर इज अ समथिंग विच इज कॉन्फरिंग अनस्टेबिलिटी टू द जीनोम एंड इन दैट सेंस जीनोम इज नॉट अ स्टेबल एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर डिस्कवरी इज डन बाय This is the part of a classical genetics. These are the stories of 1940s. And henceforth, majority of things are later on cleared as far as transposable elements are concerned. But whether it is a Mendel or whether there are so many scientists are there, or including the Barbara McIntosh, whatever prediction, whatever study they have analyzed, that is appropriate one, correct one. And in later on stages, it is revealed that it is the truth. Even current molecular biology protocols or sequencing protocols when they are used at that time, whatever discoveries they have made, that find that are the very much correct. And henceforth, these are very important thing. Here, there are the two tasks we have to complete. The first thing is that what is the nature of a transposable element in a G-maize or in a corn plant, that we have to clear. And also, along with that, we are also going to clear our concept as far as historical development of discovery of transposable element is concerned. Because transposable element of G-maize, whenever we study, at that time, we are also studying the historical development or how the Barbara McIntosh concluded about this or traced out about the transposable element. Already I have given the things, and this is a very important discovery as far as the biology is concerned. Henceforth, Barbara McIntosh is awarded by Nobel Prize in 1983 for this particular contribution. You might recall the things which are learned during 11th and 12th biology classes, that there is a meiosis. Actually, the plant possesses the two important component, male component, female component, androecium, gynoecium, stigma, pistil, stamen, such kind of nomenclature might know to you. These are very much important. And now what happens, whenever the pollen grains are formed or whenever the eggs are get formed, eggs within a female, within a stigma, ovary, there is the meiosis takes place, and generally all the cells of this particular plant possesses the two sets of a chromosome. This is very well known to you. Okay, and from that several cells are undergoes a meiosis, and that forms the sex cells or the spores. Okay, and these are nothing but the cells which are involved as far as the sexual reproduction is concerned. So these pollen, within a pollen grain, and these are the things which are present, and within an egg, these are the present. And whenever both are get combined, at that time, fertilization takes place, then zygote takes place, and then there is a embryo is developed. This is the story of a seed development. Okay, not only about the corn, but generally we are applicable to the all plants. So this is not new for you, I think. You're already aware about this particular concept during 12th year study. But along with the fertilization, we know that in case of a plant, there is a double fertilization. Okay. At two reasons, the fertilization takes place. And after a double fertilization, whatever zygote is developed, and then it develops the seed. Okay, and from that seed, once again the plant is generated. From the plant, haploid cells are generated. Once again, sexual reproduction in that way. This is referred as the life cycle of a plant. Okay, this is the gametophyte. This is the sporophyte. Such kind of a terminology is known. I want to particularly concentrate as far as this reason is concerned. Okay, or particularly double fertilization. If this double fertilization is clear, then it is easy to grasp the topic. Okay, keep in mind that the Barbara McIntosh was a cytogenetics. She also aware regarding to the major details regarding to the cytology, cell biology, and along with that she also try to know what is actually happens at the genetic level. You must know, as per just for your information, you should know that 2N means 20 in case of G males, and N means 10. Haploid, diploid. Diploid means 20. 20 chromosomes are there, and in haploid, 10 chromosomes are there. Okay, that is not important here. Just what is important is a double fertilization. Although majority of you are aware regarding to double fertilization, but I am going to give you the details. When the pollen grains are deposited on the stigma, this is the female flower part, and this is coming from the male flower. So this male gametophyte, which is haploid one, sperms are there. So these sperms are deposited here, and from here there are two things are there. One is the female gametophyte. So this is the female gametophyte. These are the egg cell, and within that a secondary endosperm nucleus is there. But actually it is not a haploid one. It is a 2N. Okay, henceforth, what is the double fertilization? In the first, the sperm nucleus, which is come from the pollen grain, this one is combined with the egg cell, and this haploid, and that forms the embryo nucleus, that is forms the zygote, and this is denoted as a 2N. This is one fertilization. But along with that, another sperm cell, another male gametophyte, it is also enter here, and it get crossed with the secondary endosperm nucleus. This is the secondary endosperm nucleus, but it is not a haploid, it is a diploid. And it's go N to N, and it forms the 3N. So this is the endosperm nucleus. This is the embryo. Okay. And now, after that, as far as this internal developments of these ovaries are concerned, once the two male gametophytes are there, one approaches to the egg nucleus and another approaches to the secondary endosperm. One forms the embryo nucleus to end, that is the zygote, while it is a triploid structure, endosperm nucleus. There, this is the fertilized egg. This is the important part as far as the cell is concerned. This is the fertilized egg. This consists of the two. But remaining endosperm is coming from the division of these endosperm nucleus. While here, each cell consists of the 3N. A fertilized egg consists of the 2N and the remaining part. Okay. So this endosperm, okay, this is the embryo, this is the endosperm. And in that way, a seed is get formed. So within a seed, the developing embryo or matured embryo, which consists of the 2N, from here the seed has to generate a new plant. But remaining thing, these are just offering a cushion to that for the nourishment. Cotyledons are for the nourishment whenever the seeds are sown, until and unless the photosynthesis not start for that purpose. And during the embryogenesis, whatever major portion which is here, it is consists of the 3N. Okay, now we come to our example of a maize. So within a maize, the embryo is there, and remaining whatever excess part you are finding, which is referred as a kernel, we also eat that. So that consists of the several cells, and all the cells possesses the 3N. Endosperm nucleus consists of the 3N, 3 sets. Okay, if it is clear, then it is very easy to grasp the chapter. Now, here, now comes to our example. What happens here in Barbaram McIntosh experiment? The genetic marker allele C locus on the short arm of the chromosome 9. Okay, this is the story of chromosome 9. We have to not consider all the chromosome. On the chromosome 9, there is a C locus. Okay, so this allele, the C prime is the dominant allele. C prime is the dominant allele, and what is its nature? It inhibitor of the aleuron coloration. So there is one G which contribute the color to that kernel endosperm. But whenever the C prime is present, this is the dominant one. Means when C prime and CC both are present at that time, C will be able to express. and whenever it is going to express, it inhibits the aleuron coloration. Means the color is absent whenever the C prime is present, this gene is present in the cell. This indicate that the kernel will be colorless. Why? Because it inhibits the color synthesizing gene, because it is the dominant. Henceforth, in the first experiment, McClintock, what she has done, she has taken the ears, generally female flower plants part is referred as the ears. The CC, what it means CC, C are the aleuron color forming gene. And but these are the simple gene, means whenever this C and this C is present, at that time the kernel will be colored. Why? Because they express the coloration, the color aleuron is the colored here. Okay, now this particular female plant, here you can imagine this particular part, it is fertilized by the pollen from the C prime tessels, male flower plants part is referred as the tessel. Okay, here for example this is the sperm. Okay, but the nature of this at the 9 chromosome C locus is the C prime. What is means C prime? This means that there is a no color formation. This is the inhibitor of a color formation. Whenever the C prime is present, this is the this. Now, when the kernels are produced as a result of the endosperm. Okay, an endosperm consists of the 3 sets of the chromosome. One is from these tessels and two are from these cells. Secondary endosperm 2. The female consists of the, already I have given the CC, and one C prime, it is coming from the pollen. And now it is a triploid. And these triploid endosperm receives 2 alleles of the female plant and one from the male parent. What do you think? What happens here? Whether the color will form or not form? Yes? In this particular triploid endosperm, what is your expectation? What is your observation based on the previous talk I have given? Not form, why not form?
Sir, C prime hai inhibitor asliamule.
Very good. There is the presence of C prime. It is inhibits the things, and most importantly, it is the dominant one. Means whenever it is present, it suppresses the effect of this, and it always responsible to stop. Means although the 2 chromosomes are there, but the, this is the this piece. Now, the same concept I explained. This is the 9th number chromosome. You might have aware regarding to the symbols. So this is the denoted the female. This is just like a mirror-like structure. Okay. Females have the attraction for the mirror, hence such typical structure is given. And this is the arrow-like structure. It is the given for the male. So this is the female gametophyte. This is the male gametophyte. We are discussing about the only the endosperm formation, not in a double fertilization. We are talking regarding only this. Okay, because the cotyledons, what happens to the cotyledons, why the different colors are there as shown in the picture that we are tracing out. Henceforth, we are just talking this thing. We are not talking regarding to this. This is the normally happens, this particular thing. So here, these are the 2 normal C are there, means they encodes for the colored and aleuron. And here, there is a C prime, which is present in the male. And now here the all the 3 combines here, and as you said that the such a thing will not produce any color. But along with that, there are also the presence of the D. I'll explain what is actually the D. The D's are responsible to break the chromosome. Okay, so example, whenever it is present, it is responsible for the breaking of the chromosome. And whenever the chromosome is get broken, at the time of separation during the mitosis and all this, you know that the spindle fibers distribute in this. Henceforth, if the cell doesn't consist of these fragmented part, detached part, if it is not got, then what happens? Once again, CC, and there is no C prime. Hence, if it is not present, then the colorless. If it is part of the cell, then it is a color. So this is referred as the eccentric fragment loss. So this eccentric fragment loss is due to the breakage at the D region. Okay, and henceforth, if these get detached, whatever kernel which is formed here, it will be the pigmented. Why pigmented? Because suppressing gene which is present there, and that part is now detached from it, and in that cell this is the thing. Okay, in that way, in the first step, maternal paternal chromosomes unite to produce the diploid endosperm. Then in second, the breakage occurs at the site D. Okay, actually these D are very much important, and due to this, this part is get detached. Now here this is intact, this is intact, but due to the absence of this, here CC and C, although the whole chromosome is present, but that particular fragment is not present. Henceforth, these kernel will produce the pigmented cell. Why? Because they possess the CC genotype. Okay, the chromosomal fragment carrying inhibitor, the pigmentation is lost as it is get lost. And you know that the significance is that it is inhibiting, but now there is no inhibition, and here the this is, although it is recessive, but it is expressed because dominant gene is absent there. Okay, that is the same thing. The break at the label by the arrow catches the segment of the chromosome in the centrum here. This is the breaking site. These are very much important. Actually, these are the component of the transposable element. Okay, so that same thing I have explained in the now. Here we should get clear regarding to the terminology. The C prime is a dominant allele on the short arm of the chromosome that prevents the color from being expressed, and henceforth this is the colorless. Whenever this gene is present, this chromosome, this allele is present, it is a colorless, or it actually responds for the white or yellow colored. Okay, so this is the known as the inhibitor allele. So this C prime is the inhibitor allele. C, and it is a dominant allele. Normal C is the recessive allele on the short arm of the same, at the same position. This is the thing, but actually it contributes for the color development. Whenever the C is present, it gives the color. Then BZ is the dominant allele in the short arm of the chromosome that leads to purple phenotype. Another reason is there, that is referred as the BZ, and whenever it is a dominant one, and whenever it is present, the kernel is from the purple color. Okay, BZ whenever present, it is the recessive part and short arm, and whenever it is present, it forms the dark brown phenotype. Okay, BZ dominant, BZ small BZ, it is the recessive, and whenever BZ is present, it is a purple, and whenever the small BZ is present, it is a dark. Then now these are the, along with this, there are the two elements are there. The first is the DS. These are the genetic location. These are not genes. These are the sequence, genetic location on the short arm of the chromosome at which chromosomal breakage occur. The chromosome can break there. Okay. So this particular region is referred as the D. Actually, only these two things are new for you, but as far as C prime, C, D are concerned, I already knew. Then along with that, A factor, that is as a satisfactory outcomes are not given, henceforth Barbara McClintock proposes the presence of the A factor, which is unknown location. Where it is present, it is not. Okay, but it is, it might be present there, and it has an impact on the expression of the T. What happens? There is the variation as far as expression of these systems. Then she has proposed that there might be additional A factor might be present, and due to that A factor, the D is affects is the changes, means whether the coloration, no coloration, whatever things are happening, that this abnormal behavior of the D is might be due to the A factor. But where is A factor? Not known, at unknown location. So that is the things she has collected the information. Now in another experiment, more sophisticated experiment, she has crossed the same logic is the same in the first experiment, whatever we had. The female that were homozygous for C. Homozygous means possesses the two equal same gamete, C and BZ. that lack the D. D is absent there. Henceforth, you have to denote like the C, C, B, Z, B, Z. B, Z is the recessive, and what is the significance of it? Whenever it is present, it is responsible for the dark brown phenotype. Okay. And here D is absent, since I have shown it with the dash dash. Dash dash means D is absent here. While male, that is homozygous, males is the, here only the C, one set is given. Okay. C prime, B, Z and D, S, it is denoted like that. Whenever these two are crossed, as the D element are there and the B, Z, B, Z is there. When B, Z is there, already given that purple phenotype is there. Okay. Now from these cross, what will be the produce? Okay. A 3N, three sets, two of these and one of these. Although two are present, but only one will be going because it is a haploid now. Male gamete is a haploid now. Okay. The heterozygous, which has an aleron layer that had the genotype. What is the genotype? C, 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 B, Z, J, because both the C are taken, both the B, Zs are taken, and one C prime and one DS is taken. And such kind of a kernel is produced. Because of the presence of the dominant inhibitor, the C prime is present here, the inhibitor is present, the offspring kernels were expected to be colorless. Here it is a colorless. Okay. And whether the BZ is present, capital BZ is present, whatever, because all colors are get should be suppressed. But this is the theoretical. But when these braids are grown for the number of times, the practically they form that these are the, there are sheds. Okay, actually what is expectation? There should be the no color should be there, but different sheds are there. Then why such kind of things are there, that we are going to here this is the colorless. Okay, actually colorless are also there, but along with the colorless a different patterns are there. Why? These are things. Okay. That along with that, McClintock also observed that the many kernels are colorless backgrounds and varying amounts of the dark brown spots or the streaks. And she concluded, means it is not universally all are colorless. Several are colorless, several show the dark brown spots, several within like a mosaic, several show the streaks like, means spots are there, streaks are there. Okay, and from this she concluded that the individual cell, those kernels have lost the seed. Means although as far as the theoretical things are concerned, these things are happens, but it might be that from where the colors are produced, these colors are produced because individually several cells may get lost this C prime, because whenever the C prime is absent, then and then color all get formed. If the C is absent, then BZ will express or the henceforth. The absence of a C prime is also cleared by she that the due to the chromosomal break at the D. Okay. And hence, without either C prime, means if the color present is not there, if the BZ is present, then the purple. If the C prime is present, colorless. If the small BZ is present, it is the brown. Depending on the D. But still the question arises, why the different patterns are there? Who decided that the C's get a detached? Or BZ is going to express and all these things. And for that purpose, the D locus is important. It is playing important role as far as these things are concerned. Okay. So here we are going to discuss one by one as far as the Baba McClintock's experiments, several experiments are concerned. So she discovered that the McClintock also performed the additional experiment that what such kind of things are happened, because actually the endosperm is should be the colorless, but why the different shades are there? They are demonstrated that the phenotypic effect of D's is depend on the presence of another element A. D is working there, which is responsible to fragmentize the chromosome, but it needs the somebody's help, and it might be the AC as she proposes. McClintock had a trouble of mapping A, C and D's. But although she has guessed that there is the involvement of AC, there is involvement of DC, but where it is actually during the mapping experiment, she always get a difficulty. She doesn't locate, means they are present there. But what is the position of them? That is can't be mapped properly. okay, henceforth nothing that can be changed their position on their chromosome in different males. So these are the different always detected in the different position. The exact mapping, exact position is not. Henceforth, the further experiment showed that the D just break the chromosome. Okay, formally she says that the D might be responsible to detach the C and C prime, and henceforth it is lost. But actually, what happens later on in experiment, she found that the D is not only responsible. Okay, one of the function is that it detaches, it break the chromosome. But every time it is not like that. It doesn't just break the chromosome, but it actually move the one chromosomal location to another. And this is actually the transposable element of this story. That is, that this D many times is responsible to detach it, but many times it is able to change its position. It goes here and there within a chromosome, and henceforth the different patterns or the different fragmentations are possible. If the D is changes the position, then different fragment will be there. If D is a change the position, then different coloring combinations might be there. Henceforth, when the D is inserted into the BZ gene, suppose if the D element are inserted into the BZ gene, it causes mutation in the BZ gene. The functioning of the BZ, because it is an intact gene and it goes there, and henceforth BZ gene's function is get hampered. Okay. Now, it destroys the ability of BZ. Henceforth, now the whatever BZ encodes for the purple color, it is not produced by that pigment. Okay, although the BZ is present, but due to the insertion of D. But always keep in mind, for the D's functionality, AC elements are important. Then D can be excised the BZ allele against only in the presence of AC, causing BZ to revert back. Once again, that can lose its position, and once again normal BZ is there, and once again the purple is. Now, think this is happening means although the first cell 3 and cell is a single one, but later on during the mitosis, okay, so many cells are there. At that time, in each cell, different consequences are taking place. Henceforth, different patterns are there. Several kernels are the colorless, several are the brown, several are the purple, several show the shade, several show the spot, several show the streaks, such kind of things, because these position is not constant, it is changing against the amount of purple or brown depend on when during the development of D is inserted. Means whether the brown color will produce, whether the purple color will be produced, whether the color release will be produced, whether the spot of the brown or the streak of this brown or the spot of the purple, what will be produced, this totally depends on the D, where the T is going to insert. If the excision happens prior to fertilization, then affected the kernel and entire purple or brown depending upon the BZ. Prior to this particular thing, at what stage these particular D elements are moving here and there, overall these has an impact, henceforth the different colored shades are there and depending on these things. Now, she says that there are the presence of A element and C element. Now, today, after the discovery of this species, she has predicted that the D's are the moving here and there, and chromosome is not a static one. Now, today we have got too much details, and now well-established facts, whatever today's knowledge, whatever the current updates as far as this transposons of the males are concerned, that we are going to discuss here. Today we know that there are the presence of AC element and there is the DS element. AC element is the activator. Activator means the intact active version of a transposon found in the maize. The active and intact. Intact means complete. Whenever it is present, it is referred as the AC element. While the DS, which is actually the abbreviation of the word dissociation, hence it is a DS and activator AC. So these are the defective, these are not intact, these are the defective version of the transposon, and they are found in the maize, cannot move alone but needs the AC element to provide the transposons. They have ability to move from here to there, they are detected to be moving from one location to another, but for moving there is the need of a AC element. Means AC is a complete and active, and DS is the defective version of the same. So this is referred as the AC-DS family of transposon. So in maize, AC-DS family is present, And today we know that these are the actually the inverted terminal repeat of the 11 base pairs insert at 8 base pair target sequence. Their target sequence is the 8 base pair target sequence, and they have the invert at terminal region. They are the invert at 11 base pairs. This concept I will also explain whenever we see the molecular biology of a transposon. Now, even we know today the AC element consists of the 4563 base pairs long, and these are the fully functional transposol. They at their own level, they can move from one location to another location. While DS elements are the vary in size, we can't predict exact size. Okay, just AC are the complete one, they are the defective one. Of course, they are the less size as compared to the 4,500. They are derived from the AC. Actually, DS elements are not separate one, they are derived actually from their generation from the AC. What happens whenever from AC, several genes, several region is get deleted. Due to the deletion, what happens? A major function is get hampered, and in that way, it becomes incomplete. Means whenever within AC, a deletion of some part or a transposer genes are deleted, at that time it get converted into DC. AC is converted to DS by whenever the deletion. If cell contains AC element wherever its DNA, then transposer enzymes made AC. If the AC is present, then the transposer enzyme will be synthesized, and then only the D element can transfer from one location to another. And so Barbara McClintock, without knowing the molecular biology and all these details, she is very much correct that for the moving the DES element, there should be the requirement of AC. What is the significance of AC? AC elements encode the enzyme transposes. Okay, and these transposes are responsible to cut and then insert these things. And so the DES elements must keep inverted repeat, otherwise AC transposes will not recognize them. So this is, I will explain one by one how they are going to insert one. But yeah, at this stage you should know that the main mesh, there is the AC-DS family is present, and their majority of things are known. Where is the, what is the nature of target site, what is the nature of the terminal ends, what is the base pairs associated with AC, what from where the DS come, and why the DS are not moving in absence of AC, that all answers are known to us now. Okay, so this is the AC elements example. This is the inverted repeat. This is, and this consists of the transposer gene. This is very much important. Suppose if deletion occurred, this part is get removed out. Okay, due to the mutation, deletion mutation. What happens? It is there, the complete gene is not there. Only incomplete gene is there. Henceforth, this becomes a DS. AC, which consists of the transposers, in absence of it, it becomes the DS. If a total absence also, partial absence also, there are the different versions of the DS element. Henceforth, although these has the ability to move from one to another, but it requires the AC element. Why? Because there is a need of a transposer. And when the inverted repeat is transposer gene, inverted repeat, this complete structure is present, it is repeated as the AC element. Whenever the deletion is takes place and DSR becomes incomplete, it becomes the DS element. These are the activator, these are the dissociation element. Okay, I think we have scarcity of time. Remaining topic I am going to discuss in the coming lecture. Okay, up to this you should clear as far as AC and DC, AC and DS elements are concerned, that are the discovered by the Barbara McClintock, and this is the today's pictures we are discussing. If you have any question as far as this part is concerned, you can ask me. Very simple part is remain, that we are going to complete in the next lecture. Yes, any question? No question? Okay, clear. Thank you for giving me a feedback. Okay, we'll meet. We'll continue the same topic. I also go start from the previous, since it will clear your understanding and the clarity as far as understanding is concerned.